Hi all, now we came out with the pin diagram of 8051 microcontroller. So actually we know that microcontroller 8051 is an 8-bit microcontroller. And this is the pinout diagram of the 8051. This has 40 pins. And this is in Dewar inline package. So this contains one side 20 pins and the another side it has 20 pins. So first of all, if we need to study the pinout diagram, first we need to mark the VCC and then the ground. So mostly in all of the ICs, VCC at this the last point, that means the 40th pin, and opposite to this one we can see the ground or VSS. So here the 20th pin is the ground and the 40th pin is VCC. Next we move to the oscillator. Since it is the next important section of the 8051. And it is connected to the 18th and 19th pin, the crystal oscillator. Crystal 2 and crystal 1 are the pins which are used for connecting crystal oscillators. Next portion is about the port. That is the port 0. It starts from the 39th pin to 32 pin. That means 8 bit. And it is naming as P0. P0 means port 0.0. The first bit of the port 0. Then P01 meaning the second bit of port 0, and here it is written AD0 to AD7. AD means address or data. That means this port 0 can transfer address and data. That's why it is written AD0, AD1, etc. And next we move to the port 1. So it is written as, since it is port 1, it is written as P1.0 to P1.7, and it is starting from 1 to 8. Next we move to the port 2. This port 2 has some difference. So if we check here, we can see P2.0, it is starting from the bottom. From bottom it is going upward. That means P2.0, P2.1, P2.2, P2.3, P2.4, etc., etc. And it goes up. In all other ports, that means P0, P1, and if we take the case of P3 also, it is starting from the top position. From the top to bottom, it is counting as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But in P2 case, it is in the reverse order. That is, from the bottom, it is starting. And next, the port 3, and it is connected to 10 to 17. And like I already told, P30 means port 3. First bit, that means P3.0. And port 3 has some other special functions. That means the first two pins is used for the serial data transfer, RxD and TxD. That means reception of the serial data and transmission of the serial data. And the other two pins for the interrupt, external interrupt. We have here two external interrupt, INT0 and INT1. Next, about the timers also, that means T0 and T1. It is used for mainly for the timers. Then external memory read or write for the reading and writing into memory. So these are the special functions of the port 3. And we have, there is a reset pin in between the port 1 and port 3. So all this side is covered now. That is, first 8 pins to port 1, then a reset pin in between here, then port 3 8-bit. 8 pins, then 2 crystal oscillator, 1 ground. And in this side, remaining 3 pins are there. And the first one is used for EA, that means external memory access, then ALE, address latch enable, and PSEN, program store enable. So now all the pins, now we are covered. Okay, thank you all. This is the pinout diagram of the 8051 microcontroller.